I'm Rev Trina. Croeso. Welcome to our service. This week, coming from Cantref Church, just outside Brecon. Cantref is in the Beacons and Fins of Adam ministry area. This is an old church with a 16th century tower and a nave that has been rebuilt in the 19th century. Cantref Parish has a distinction of having Pen y Fan within its parish boundary. Please join in. All the words for the hymns and the prayers are provided. Thank you. An opening prayer for all those suffering from disaster, illness and grief. Father of mercies, God of comfort, we ask you to look in tender love on your sorrowing servants. Be to them their refuge, strength, and very present help in their troubles. Help them to know the love of Christ, which has opened the gates of everlasting life. In your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Chapter 14, verses 22 to 33. Immediately Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowd. After he had dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. Later that night he was there alone, and the boat was already a considerable distance from land, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. Shortly before dawn, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they cried, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I. Don't be afraid." "Lord, if it's you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." "Come," he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid, and beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God."
Reflection on the Gospel reading, Matthew chapter 14, verses 22 to 33. Matthew's account relates to a time just after Jesus had heard about John's execution, which was a turning point in Jesus' ministry, a time when he was facing his own death. He had taken himself away from his disciples to be alone in order to pray. The disciples were on the Sea of Galilee, which they knew very well. A storm blew up, and Jesus continued to pray, leaving them in their boat to confront their own fears. As early morning came, Jesus walked out to them and identified himself. He urged them to take courage and said, "It is I." In other words, "I am the name of God." Jesus demonstrated his divine powers by walking on water and causing the storm to subside, but not before Peter, in an impetuous way, had challenged Jesus to call him to walk across the water to Jesus. Peter started out really well, but then it seems that fear and then doubt intervened, and he started sinking. Jesus took Peter's hand and guided him to safety, chastising him for having little faith and doubting Jesus. But we really have to admire Peter's bravery for going over the side of the boat in a storm simply because Jesus had called him. It showed tremendous faith, at least at the outset. So what went wrong? Why did Peter sink? It seems as though panic set in, and he suddenly became afraid of what he was doing, which meant his faith lessened. He needed total faith in order to walk to Jesus. In many ways, this text is about the relationship between Jesus and the disciples. It could be understood as Jesus using this opportunity of a storm and the terror of those in the boat to increase their faith in God and their trust in him. It also seems that Peter wanted to be the first of the disciples to show how much he trusted in Jesus and that his faith was up to the challenge. It nearly was. This impacting story was a way of early Christians being able to understand the dominion of Creator God over his creation and to recognize Jesus as the Son of God. For this, the most image-filled and impacting of Jesus' miracles. This has been a significant inclusion in the creeds, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Such profound imagery has made this miracle a reference point in everyday modern language, though in a different context. We talk about someone who is being described as very impressive, and a response might well be, "And can he walk on water too?" to perhaps indicate a scepticism of this described person's abilities, in effect, comparing him to Jesus' miracle. This miracle, taken out of context, is impacting for its own sake alone. However, in the Old Testament, the sea is used to symbolize chaos and was something to be greatly feared. Jesus walking on water symbolized God's control over the elements, including the chaotic sea. What we are being told in this text is that Christians should not be afraid of the chaotic elements of nature or life, but instead they should place their complete trust in God. This whole text is about faith, what faith means, how powerful it can be, and how we can use our faith to gain salvation. It is a powerful image of what happens if we falter in our faith. Jesus is there for us if we trust in him. Jesus wasn't initially recognized as he approached the boat. He appeared as a ghost to the overwrought disciples at the mercy of the waves. This is significant in suggesting that perhaps we don't always recognize Jesus in our lives, and we need to have more faith in order to let him into our lives. In a way, the boat could represent our lives, and crossing the sea is our journey in life, sometimes calm and ordered, sometimes out of our control and chaotic. If we cling to our old lives, the boat, and don't let go, then we're not being open to a new life based on faith. The description of Peter's attempts to walk to Jesus encapsulates the concept of faith. Without faith, we sink. With faith, we have eternal hope. Amen.
To guide us into all truth. So rule our lives by your power, that we may be truthful in thought and word and deed. May no fear or hope ever make us false in act or speech. Cast out from us whatever moves us to lie to ourselves and others, and bring us into the perfect freedom of your truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, in whom nothing can live but live in love, grant us the spirit of love, which does not seek reward or honour, but only the blessing and happiness of everything. Love is the very joy of life, your goodness and truth within the soul, from here to eternity. Amen. We say together our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Praise is thy name, O Lord, O God, my Father, where is no shadow to thee?
our final prayer. Lord, we do not pray for tasks that are equal to our strengths. We pray for strength equal to our tasks, now and every day, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Take us and use us to love and serve you and all people, in the power of your Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you always, and those you love, forevermore. Amen.